Hello students, good morning everyone. Yesterday we will discuss about acid, base and salt, neutralization reaction and about salt. Now our next chapter, that is physical and chemical change. This is 7th class science topic. In our surrounding, we look carefully, then we observe many type of change take place. There are many examples which give us many type of change, such as when we burn a piece of paper, we saw many fruits ripen. We cook food, we throw many waste materials from our houses. The cooked food become destroyed. These are many examples which represent different type of changes, and we observe these changes in our everyday life. These changes are either physical change or chemical change. Physical change, first we will discuss about physical change. Physical change is also known as reversible change. A change that can be reversed means when we burn a piece of paper, then we cannot get back this piece of paper. Or when we fold up the piece of paper in two or three layers, just like as this is a paper, when we fold this paper first in one round and this is our second round, after opening first round and second round, we will get original paper back. This is the reversible change or physical change. A change that can be reversed easily, or there is no new substances formed. There is no new substance is formed. Then this is the physical change or reversible change. There are many examples in our daily life, such as we cut a piece of paper, we fold a piece of paper, fold a piece of paper and in physical change, the texture of the substance, color of the substance remains same. Okay, now characteristics of physical change. First characteristics is that there is no new substances formed in this type of physical change. For example, ice melts to form water, and water further converted into vapor, vapors back converted into water, and water back converted into ice. When ice on heating, we get water, and on further heating, we get water vapors. When temperature is decreased, means on cooling, we get water from water vapors, and on further cooling we get ice from water. This is our daily life example of physical change, in which ice means we get the states, many states of water, that is solid, liquid or gaseous states. There is no new substance we get in this type of change. Okay, after that, second one, the change is temporary, means it is not a permanent change, and this change is reversible change. Not a permanent change, this change is reversible change. For example, when we stretch a rubber band, then the shape of this rubber band changes, but after leaving it, we get its original shape. Means there is a temporary change take place. Similarly, inflating a balloon. Inflating means to fill air into the balloon. Inflating balloon, when we fill the air into the balloon with our mouth in a proper way, not much excess, then this balloon inflated, and when we release this air by opening its mouth, we get our original balloon. It does not burst. When we fill a excess amount of air into it, then the balloon will burst. But in a limited amount, we get inflated balloon. And inflating a balloon is the example of a physical change. The shape of the balloon will be changed, and change is the temporary or reversible change, but not a permanent change, and no new substance is formed in this type of a change. Okay, students, after that, next is, there is no loss or gain of energy take place. There is no, there is no loss or gain of energy take place. Because we study in higher classes the law of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy means energy gets converted from one form to another form, but there is in actual no loss or gain of energy take place. Either heat energy is converted into electric energy, or electric energy is converted into light energy, or just as heat or light are just converted into chemical energy, etc. But there is actual no loss or gain of energy take place. The amount of energy which is required to physical change is just as when we heat the 1 gram of substance, then this much amount of energy is equals to the energy which is required in physical change. Actual no loss or gain of energy take place, and net change in energy is zero. Net energy change is zero. Okay, After that, no change in mass of the substance. There is no change in weight of the substance. Just as law of conservation of energy, we also discuss law of conservation of mass. In a chemical reaction, A and B are the reactants which react together, and C and D are the two products which are formed after the reaction of A and B. Then the total mass of the reactant is equals to the total mass of the product. We will prove this in higher classes according to law of conservation of mass. Means before reaction, the mass of the reactant is a constant and there is no change in mass after reaction. The total mass of the reactant before reaction is equals to the total mass of the product after reaction. Similarly, means when we take one glass of water and we gets converted either into its steam, vapor, or its in solid state, that is ice, then the mass of water and ice is equals. And in actual, there is no change in mass take place. Mass of the substance remains the same. Okay, students, after that, we explain this physical change by giving some examples. And you have to write the observations. What you observe? First one is switch on the bulb. When we switch on the bulb, what will you observe? The bulb glows. We observe the bulb glows and it produces heat as well as light. It produces heat as well as light. It means this change is physical change, because no new substance is formed when we switch off the bulb, then bulb is original. After that, second, when we rub a magnet on steel rod, after rubbing magnet, we do not get any change in magnet or in steel rod. What will you observe? The steel rod gets magnetized. Steel rod gets magnetized because on rubbing magnet, the steel rod gets magnetized and it shows the properties of magnet and it attracts the salt in a pieces of paper or small tiny pieces of iron. After that, next is when we dissolve sugar or salt into water. After dissolving sugar or salt into water, what will you get? The sugar or salt after some time completely dissolves into water and it disappears into water. Means completely dissolve into water, sugar or salt, and it disappears. But this common salt or sugar can also be get back by using simple evaporation method. We can get back sugar or salt in this method. So these are the some examples of physical change. Okay, students. After that, in next class, we will discuss about chemical change. Thank you.